Hey guys, it's me again. In this video, we're going to talk about how stress affects your brain. Now, this is interesting because there's a hormone called cortisol. It's triggered by stress. And what this hormone does is it depletes the brain of oxygen. So that can slowly start wearing out the short-term memory, like with names, and then you'll have problems with forgetting where you are in time and space, like, okay, where am I going? Where did I park? Like locational issues. And then it becomes worse and worse and worse. That's a high level of stress that can affect the memory and affect brain problems, right? But there's something else that I think that's even more common, and it can come from cortisol. Cortisol releases a lot of insulin, and it's behind a lot of diabetes. So insulin resistance is a condition of pre-diabetes. So what is insulin resistance? It's basically insulin is too high for too long, and it blocks the absorption into the cells, into the brain. So you have a situation where you can't get glucose into the brain anymore. You can't get fuel to the brain. You can't get nutrition to the brain. What do you think the brain's going to do? You're going to get brain fog. You're going to have memory problems. And you're going to get dementia or Alzheimer's. I believe, this is my personal opinion, that Alzheimer's is really a severe case of an insulin problem, whether it's insulin resistance or a full-blown diabetes. Even call it type 3 diabetes. In fact, if you type on Google, you can pause this video and type on Google, just type on Alzheimer's and insulin resistance and see what pops up, because it really makes a lot of sense when you think about it, because that brain is being starved of food coming from the insulin resistance. So how do you fix that? Well, before I get into how to fix it, and I have a lot of videos on that you can watch, think about after a Thanksgiving meal where you eat all this food and you get really tired in your head. That's high sugar, right? Because the insulin's not there to pull it out. So that could be one situation as well. Or if the sugar goes low, you could have like hyperirritability and get very cranky. So when you're running on sugar, the fluctuations of high and low, or even insulin resistance, really messes with your brain. Your brain does not do good if there's fluctuations in too much sugar or not enough sugar, okay? That's why ketosis is a better way to go. But the thing to do is to heal the insulin dysfunction, okay? How do we do it? We have to cut out the sugar, okay? And I'm just going to summarize here, but you can go to the other videos. You have to cut out the sugar. We have to somehow fix what's causing the insulin going up, like high levels of stress. We have to fix the stress. We have to get you to sleeping at night. We can't have 6 meals a day. We can't have snacks between the meals. We need 3 meals a day, maybe even twice. If you're not hungry in the morning, skip breakfast, okay? So why? Because if we don't eat, we lower insulin between the meals. So we cut out the sugar. We have 3 meals a day. We don't snack, okay? And what gets you to go from one meal to the next is a little bit more fat. Fat will not hurt you. It'll help you. Of course, we need a lot of vegetables as well, for the potassium to help store your sugar between meals, and also you need the nutrition to actually support the whole body in general. But these are the two hormones that are involved with cognitive function. And if you can improve these, you'll see great improvements in the brain itself, okay? Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.